Here I have quite a bunch of transistors, and I want to make a Darlington. And we know that a Darlington consists of two transistors. One is the driver and one is the end transistor. All regarding this circuit that I'm working on, it's a square wave oscillator for low frequencies. And I want to make a Darlington end stage for that circuit, so that I have an output voltage from, say, between 0 and 15 volts. Anyway, here are all these solvers. Transistors, and it's important when you want to make a selection that you know how the Darlington works. And the Darlington is in fact very simple. The first transistor and the end transistor, they both amplify, and the output amplification is the amplification factor from the first transistor multiplied by the second transistor. So here some examples. When the first transistor amplifies 100 times and the second transistor 10 times, the total amplification is 1000. And here we have other values. When they both amplify 50 times, the amplification factor is 2500. And the good thing from it all is that when you mount here a capacitor, this is by the way a classic series regulator, when you mount here a capacitor, the value from the cap that the electronic circuit sees at its output is defined by the amplification factor and the value from the cap. So a 1 microfarad cap here means that the electronic circuit at its output sees a cap from 100 microfarad, etc., etc. Very simple to understand. But we have, of course, not only a Darlington in a power supply circuit, we can also have a Darlington as an amplifier, and that's here. And of course the same principles can be applied. The first transistor here has an amplification from 10, and this for instance from 100, total amplification is 1000. In many cases, the first transistor, the driver, has a high amplification and the end transistor has a lower amplification. So many times here 100 and here 10 or 50, and the total amplification is very high. That means that when you send in here a signal, I haven't drawn this part of the circuit, but you can send here in a signal from a certain frequency, whatever frequency in the audio band for instance, via a capacitor from say 470 nanofarad, this combination is driven into saturation. That means that the maximum current flows here, and you find here a voltage drop on the frequency where you have driven the circuit in. So here a cap, bridge this of course, and here you send in a small signal from say 0.8 volts or so. Here you find a big voltage drop on the same frequency. Of course when all is aligned well And that's the reason why I use here a 1 mega ohm potentiometer to set the Darlington to its working point. You can also use here a 470k potentiometer. That was more or less all to tell. Here are the pin connections. All these principles are very simple and very easy to find out. In the situation from saturation, that the transistor is driven out completely, you can use Ohm's law, etc. So I have to do some work searching out here from this big bunch two transistors that have a good high a good amplification factor, and I will do that with the help of the transistor tester. No problem at all.